go over some stuff that I missed in the first video. This piston right here, I didn't show taking out this piston right here. It's the one that goes around the oil pump. It's a piston, just like those other ones that I replaced. It's got that check ball in it, and that has to line up with this first reverse drum. I showed that in the video, but I didn't show taking this part out right here. Pull it out, and when you put it back in, you have to line it up with this piece right here. If you put this piece in first, you can mark where that check ball is. So when you put this in, and what you can do is you can use the pump to kind of pull up on this piece right here and move it, turn it until you get it to where it'll line up when you put this piece in right here. This is what the piston looks like. This is basically, this is the check ball that you have to line up with the that first reverse drum piece.
I checked the level. I put about a gallon and just a little over a gallon in there, and it seems like it's got enough in there. More than what it's supposed to.
Should be all right. Yeah.
Well, I was shifting it and it was going in gear and everything. All right, well, it's shifting. It's a little rough. I think that brake band needs to be readjusted. I don't know, that 2.5 times. I don't know if that's the right. I'm gonna tighten it up a little and see what happens.
Thank you.
success on this one. The car doesn't have a, the car still has like a, it doesn't want to accelerate like it should. I think it's probably the exhaust is not 100%. So I didn't really do anything in the valve body. The only thing I replaced was that there's like an accumulator in there. So I replaced that, but other than that, I didn't touch the valve body at all. I took it out and looked and see if there's anything that looked wrong with it. I took it out and looked at the valve body, but I didn't do any kind of like, I just put it back in, but I did replace that accumulator that's in there. Thank you.
Okay, I'm gonna be putting this back in now. Looks like I got everything on there. The book I have says there's three O-rings on here. I don't see three, I only see two. So wait, this one, and this isn't really an O-ring. It says there's three. That book might cover a different transmission as well. This is the transmission fluid that I used, and it seems to be working fine. The book says to use Dextron 2 or 3. I can't remember which one it was, but the book says to use Dextron. This is the fluid that I use, and it's working, seems to be working all right.